What's up, everybody? I'm Sly, the movie guy, and here's my movie review of Jungle Cruise, directed by Jomay Collect. Sarah, apologize if I said your name incorrectly, starring Dwayne The Rock Johnson, Emily Blunt, and the rest of the other casting crew. And in this film, Dr. Lily Houghton enlists the aid of wisecracking skipper Frank Wolf to take her down the Amazon in his ramshackle boat. Together, they search for an ancient tree that holds the power to heal, a discovery that will change the future of medicine. Sorry for being late on this review. I was busy at the time when this film got released, but I was still anxious of checking it out because I'm a big fan of The Rock, and Emily Blunt is like one of my favorite actresses in Hollywood. So them two in the same film, I couldn't wait to like check it out and stuff. I wouldn't say this was like my high anticipated film, but it was something, a film I was looking forward to because it was an action adventure vibe and stuff with the jungle and stuff like that. So I was just like, wow, this looks incredible and stuff. And I've seen the trailers and the posters of it. So I was like, okay, this is something around my alley because I love action adventure stuff like that. So I was willing to check this film out and stuff. And I checked that on Disney Plus, and all I got to say is I definitely enjoyed it. I wouldn't say this is like a perfect movie and all that, but I definitely enjoyed it. And one of the things I did enjoy about this movie is that, like I said, the action and adventure vibe to it. It definitely has all that stuff in here. I mean, it felt like something like you seen from like the Pirates of the Caribbean and Indiana Jones and stuff. It had that type of vibe to it, and I thought that really worked in this movie and stuff. And the way it was just, it was done and stuff like that, that you didn't see like the surprising stuff that happens in this movie, you didn't see coming. And some stuff in the movie can be a little bit kind of like predictable at some parts and stuff that you can see happen a mile away. There's like stuff like when it came to like the characters, like when they were like in danger or something like that in the movie, which I won't get any spoilers, but it's one part of the movie I was like, okay, I know that ain't real and stuff. So when that happened, I was kind of like, okay, I kind of knew it. But for the most part, I did feel like some of the characters, like they were very in danger and stuff like that. So I felt that throughout the movie, and it was like in a roller coaster ride and stuff. So I felt like there was like stuff, moments where I was like on the edge of my seat, didn't know what was going to happen and stuff like that, if our characters were going to survive and stuff. So that really worked well and stuff. And the characters' interaction when it came to Emily Blunt's character and the Ross character, you get to see that relationship build up in the beginning of the movie when she meets the Rock character. And I thought it really worked well. I thought it really sets up like what we can see, what our characters are about and stuff, their personality and stuff. We get to know the Ross personality, we get to know Emily Blunt's character and stuff. So I thought that was really good. So we get to see their chemistry and stuff, their relationship. So I thought that really worked well, because action adventure movies I've seen like in the past recent years, some of the chemistry can be a little bit off, and I thought in this movie it absolutely worked well. So in this case, it definitely won me over when it came to the Rock and Emily Blunt's character. And I thought them two, their performance was absolutely fantastic. I mean, the Rock and Emily Blunt, they are fantastic together. Their chemistry was just on point. It was just fantastic on so many levels, including the actor that plays her brother and stuff. He was really good. I thought all their chemistry, all three of them together on screen, really worked well. And when they were on this adventure and stuff, and we get to see what her character is about and stuff, where she's like anxious of finding this healing tree or whatever and stuff like that, and her brother comes on an adventure and they ask the Rock for some help and stuff to get there on his cruise because he's the skipper. I thought it definitely worked well. It was definitely fun. The action in this movie definitely was a win-win here. I'd say some of it was kind of here, was okay here and there, but for the most part, I really enjoyed the action here and stuff. It wasn't like the best action, I wouldn't say like the best like in 2021, but it was really good enough, kept me on the edge of my seat for the most part. The CGI in here kind of can be questionable. Some of it can be a little bit here and there, kind of like, some of it was like okay. When it came to like the Jaguar, which is like in this movie, it was okay and stuff. I mean, since I've seen like the Lion King and the Disney stuff with their their CGI and stuff, the animation. I felt like this one was kind of like, can we question here? But I'll say it was okay. It wasn't like atrociously bad. I wouldn't say it like it was like horrible, like Mortal Kombat Annihilation bad of CGI. It was okay. It didn't ruin the movie for me. So I thought all that stuff really worked well. And the tone in this movie definitely worked. It had like a little bit like the serious parts and the emotional elements here and the comedy and stuff. So all that blends very well. It didn't like take me out of the movie on certain parts of it. Some jokes I might say did work, but some of them like, And when it comes to The Rock and Emily Blunt, it definitely balanced off very well, where The Rock is very comedic as the character, Skipper, and Emma Blunt's character is very serious and stuff. Don't know if she can trust him or not and stuff. It definitely worked well in the film, and I thought it helped the story throughout from the beginning, middle, and end. So I definitely thought it was good and stuff throughout the film. Now my negatives for the film. I felt like the runtime in this film, it was just too long. It could have been shortened up because at times, like when we got to like the action and adventure stuff, it kind of like in the middle towards, like I say in the middle of the film, it does become like a little bit of a slow burn and stuff when it comes to like exhibition and stuff like that, which I don't mind some exhibition stuff, but it came to a point where it kind of got boring where I was like, let's get to the next part and stuff. So that was like one of my negatives and stuff. I felt like the runtime was just a little bit too long. It could have been shortened up. Then the villains in this film, which I was kind of a little bit disappointed. I wish it had like a good, like a villain presence here, because at times when it came to like Jesse Plemons character and stuff, he wasn't interesting. And that's crazy because Jesse Plemons is a really good actor, and I was hoping he was like a good villain here, but throughout the film he just was kind of generic. He just like a villain just to keep the movie, like the plot going and stuff, but he doesn't do anything like interesting here. So I thought that was like one of the negatives and stuff. Then it was like the other people that was villains in the film, which we get a backstory and stuff with them, but they weren't interesting, along with Jesse Plemons' character. So I felt like the villains would have worked in this film, but throughout the film, they were okay. Wasn't the best villains. And that's pretty much all I got to say. Overall, this movie, I think, is very fun and stuff and all that. I think you have a great time watching it. If you have Disney Plus, I recommend you checking it out. And overall, I'm going to give this film a solid B. Let me know in the comment section down below what you think about this movie. Did you like it or not? Let me know. And let me know, what is your favorite action and adventure movie? For me, I'll say Raiders of the Lost Ark and Indiana Jones, The Last Crusade. So those are one of my favorite movies that deals with like action and adventure and stuff. But let me know in the comment section down below what you think about it and stuff and everything about this film. And that's pretty much it. And as always, if you like this video, click thumbs up. And if you're new to the channel, click subscribe and the bell button for more future content. That's all. I can see you next time on Slide the Movie Guy. Peace.